I was with him before coming here. He expressed his pride in you. His love.
Emotional disarray was a symptom of the illness from which he suffered.
No. Those feelings came from his heart. He shared them with me. I know.
Sarek would no more approve my coming here than you do, Picard. For some time now, I've been aware of a growing movement here of people who seek to learn the ideals of the Vulcan philosophy. They've been declared enemies of the state. But there are a few in the Romulan hierarchy, like Pardek, who are sympathetic. He asked me to come now because he believes it may be time to take the first step toward reunification.
Reunification? After so many centuries? After so many fundamental differences have evolved between your peoples?
It would seem unlikely to succeed, but I cannot ignore the potential rewards that a union between our two worlds would bring.
What is this first step that Pardek suggests?
There is a new proconsul in the Romulan Senate. He is young and idealistic. He has promised many reforms. Pardek believes that he may be receptive to discussing reunification.
Why would you not bring something so important to the attention of your own people or the Federation?
A personal decision, Captain. Perhaps you're aware of the small role I played in the overture to peace with the Klingons.
History is aware of the role you played, Ambassador.
Not entirely. It was I who committed Captain Kirk to that peace mission, and I who had to bear the responsibility for the consequences to him and to his crew. Quite simply, I am unwilling to risk anyone's life but my own on this occasion. So I ask that you respect my wishes and leave.
Ambassador, your logic escapes me. If I didn't know better, I would say that your judgment is influenced by your emotions.
You speak as my father would if he were here, Picard.
I speak as a Starfleet officer, and I cannot ignore the risks to you.
I was involved with cowboy diplomacy, as you describe it, long before you were born.
Nevertheless, sir, I'm not prepared to leave until your affairs are complete.
In your own way, you are as stubborn as another captain of the Enterprise I once knew.
And I'm in good company, sir.